Good morning. Today we will see the topic capacitor. Now, capacitor is a device for storing the large quantity of electric charge. Two conductors are arranged to form a capacitor. Thus, capacitor possesses a large capacitance to store the electric charge and that too in small shape. So, capacitor, one thing, it is a device. For what? For storing large quantity of electric charge. And another, the arrangement of the conductor. There is the two conductors when arranged, means when bring together very close to each other, on that case it gains the ability to store the electric charge, large amount of electric charge. Now, on what principle the capacitor works? So first of all we see the principle of the capacitor, that principle of capacitor. Principle of capacitor. We know that every conductor, the conductor having the ability to store the charge. Let's suppose that this is the conductor on any plate and it stores the charge, means the charge is supplied to the conductor, and gradually we know that whenever the work on the conductor, on that case its potential also increase, so it gained the potential V, or that potential is the maximum potential. Now the charge is given by any source. Whenever the charge is forced to go move into the conductor, that is because the charge, another charge will not allow to move that one. But whenever we apply the source may be of the battery, on that case let's suppose that the charge is here, the source is here, the charge is here, and these are the points where the potentials we observe. Suppose the potential at this point. So on that case, that is the charge Q by V, or Q by R, or we can say that the 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and that is the potential at the point V. Suppose the potential at the point where the plate is placed, on that case the charge is stored, and that gains the maximum potential V. So this is the simple one thing, that the plate has the potential of maximum, and if we supply another charge, on that case the charge will move or leak to the surroundings. Now, one, as we know that the capacitance is equal to Q by V. That means charge is the constant and the potential varies. Means if the potential decreases, obviously the capacitance increases. So that is the capacitance is inversely to that of the potential of the plate. Now how we reduce the potential? For that we arrange the, just see the figure here, it is the plate and having the charges. Now bring the another plate close to this one, and this plate, whenever this is the A and this one is the B, when the plate B is very close to this one, there is the induction of the charge induced in the plate B, and in front of the positive charge it is the negative one, and away from this face is the positive one. Now how can we know that the potential of this will reduce? So in that case, let's suppose it has the potential of, let it be the 10 volt. We know that according to this, at the distance of whatever may be, that potential, that is the minus V here, and that minus V, let's suppose that minus V of the minus 4 volt. Again, now this positive is also induced here. On that case, if we see the potential of this positive, on that is equal to, not equal to that of the minus 4, because it is very close, much closer than that of the other phase, this one. So potential here is the minus 4, and here that become the, let it be the 3 volt. To understand this one, how the ability to store the charge, how this charge storing ability will increase. So on that case, now if we consider net potential here in this system, on that case V is equal to 10 volt plus 3 volt minus 4 volt, and that is equal to how much? That is the 9 volt feet amperes. 9 volt. How much it becomes? Nine volt is the potential here. Now, this time the potential of the plate A reduced to 9 volt. So, most charge is supplied to that of the A. Again, to raise its potential to that of the maximum. And maximum is what? Let's suppose it be the 10 volt. Let's suppose it will be the 10 volt. So, this is the one condition we applied, that the another conductor is placed where the charge is induced. Now, in the next step, to more and more charge to be stored by the plate A, on that case, we arrange the, let's see this one. This is the plate A, and nearby plate is the B, where the negative is induced, and this one positive is here, farther face will be the positive one. And now we arrange it, or the plate B will be earthened. On that case, what we observe, that the positive will vanish. That means we know that the flow of the charge, actually what happened, that electrons move, negative charge will move, positive charge never moves. So on that case, from the earth, the negative charge will be supplied and reach it, counterbalance to the positive charge or neutralize to the positive charge. So, and that positive, all the positive will be moved out, that get neutralized due to the flow of the negative charge from the earth. This is the correct concept, that electrons are moving. If we say that the positive also move to the earth, it is the way we can explain. But actually what happened, that the negative from the earth will move and neutralize the positive of this one. So on that case, the B plate become completely negative one. Now, if we consider the previous some supposition, that the potential of the negative is the minus 4 volt, and the potential needed to the maximum of this one is the 10 volt. So now, what happened to the net potential of the system of these two plates? That is the V potential is equal to 10 volt minus 4 volt. That means what we observe here, that the 6 volt is remaining. That means the potential is reduced, and potential reduced, that means the capacitance, means storing ability, means the work, capacitance, capacity to do work. Work is needed more and more to raise that potential of this plate. So on that case, further charge will be supplied to that of the plate A. Earlier the charge was different. In the second step, more charge is given. In the third step, where the large amount of potential is reduced, more and more charge is given to further increase the potential to the maximum of the plating. So at last, if we consider that at any numerical value of this one, let it be the 10 charges, Coulomb charge is here, and here we supply 2 more charge, on that case it becomes the 12 charge by the number, let it be. And here suppose we provide the more and more of the 4 charge, so net charge in this plate become the 16 Coulomb. So what we observe earlier, the same plate acquire only the 10 charges, that store only the 10 charges, whereas when it is closed with the another plate which is earthen, on that case it acquired the maximum of the 16 charges. What happened? That means the ability of the plate A increased by the support of the second plate. And so all the total condition, if we consider, total condition if we consider, then it become the system, and that system is called, that become the system, and that system is called, is the capacitor. Means whole of this particular is called capacitor. So capacitor is a device for large storing of the charges, and it is the arrangement of two conductor very close to each other, and that is the capacitor. Storing ability will increase. Now next day we will discuss about the parallel plate capacitor. Okay.